Hello and welcome to newstation.in. Today we have someone who wielded the violin at the age of 7, and since then there's no looking back. From there he moved on to a journey and has shared the stage with the likes of Sting, none other than Mr. Sharad from Mrigya. Hello sir.
Hello, how are you?
Sir, first things first, about your interest in music, at the age of 7 you started, something about that.
Well, basically music was there in the house, in my family, you know, my guru, my teacher, Pandit Joy Srivastava, I learned under him. So it has always been, you know, I have always seen, you know, musicians coming to my house and learning from my grandfather. So when I was very small, I developed a taste towards violin.
Can you name a few musicians who would come to meet your grandfather?
Well, at that time, my grandfather, we were living in Allahabad, and the great maestro Pandit Kanthe Maharaji, Pandit Kishan Maharaji, Pandit Ravi Shankar, Baba Alauddin Khan Sahab, they all used to come to our house, because as we know that All India Radio was first opened in Allahabad. So all these maestros, these big gurus would come to perform in Allahabad. So they never used to stay in a hotel. They would always stay in our house. So this is something, you know, which I've always seen from my childhood. And my grandfather getting students from, you know, America, Europe, UK. And all the time they are practicing music in the house. So it was a very natural phenomena to learn the violin.
Why the violin?
Why not the violin? Because violin has always been very close to my heart, and I have always seen my grandfather playing so beautifully. So, yeah, it was very obvious to take up the instrument.
As you moved ahead in your life, the musical journey, you came across the likes of Parikrama. Please tell us something about your association with Parikrama.
Parikrama has been a very integral part of my musical journey, because before Mrigya, I was with Parikrama. I joined the band in 1992 and played till about 2003. Parikrama was one band when you still, you know, when you're out of school and you are joining a rock band in college. So that was the thing that, you know, was very, very challenging, at the same time very interesting, because that was the time when I learned to play with, you know, like drums, guitars, bass, and all these, you know, heavy instruments. And to make a mark with your violin was very challenging. But, you know, I think we did a great job. We were doing all kinds of rock numbers, and we were playing covers to originals. And violin was quite an important part in Parikrama then. It still is, yes.
When we talk about the international music, the name Sting, Mr. Gordon Summer, is a phenomena, and it's, in himself is a university. And you have been in the same frame, on the same league. How about the experience, and how did it happen?
So this was in 1998, Channel V Music Awards, when Sting was to perform in Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, and I was auditioned for that concert, and thankfully, you know, luckily I got selected to play with Sting. So he was in Delhi for about 4 days. I was with him, and he chose to play two songs, Fields of Gold, mm-hmm. and Every Breath You Take. And I mean, so that concert in Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium had violin, and there was a tabla player, and there was a sitar player. So we did an acoustic, beautiful acoustic set on these two songs with Sting. And it was a beautiful experience, you know, working with him.
How were you feeling before you actually met the person?
Well, it was like a wow, you know. I mean, this is, you know, it was like, is it for real that I'm going to meet Sting? You know, that kind of feeling. But, you know, he's such a humble, genuine, simple person. You know, he does yoga, he goes to the Himalayas, and, you know, he does meditation and everything, you know. And he was asking me about Indian classical music, you know, when we were speaking, you know. And I gave him a lot of my grandfather's recordings. And he was interested in the Dhrupad style of singing and all of that. So he's very much into Indian music, yoga and meditation. And not many people know that he comes to India almost every year, very discreetly. And he goes to Banaras, he goes to the Himalayas, he goes to Dharamshala. And nobody gets to know about it.
Well, that is some news. We'll try to get you and Sting together. And coming to Mrigya, what is the concept? Mrigya?
Well, Mrigya is basically a band that happened by accident.
By accident?
Yeah. So we were supposed to play a concert within 1 week to prepare for one concert.
That was in
1999. And we just got together thinking that we will play this concert and that's it. We are not going to be carrying on with this music. But then the organizer came and, you know, said in my ears that you guys are going to Edinburgh next year. The sound of the band, that first concert was so fresh and new, raga-based fusion. And then we were like, you know, immediately our journey started and we thought, okay, Mrigya has taken off. And, you know, we were on the move. We started playing festivals everywhere in the world. Yeah.
So the concept of fusion was always there from the beginning.
The concept of fusion then was a very new term in 1999. But now, 17 years later, it's a very common term. Fusion music, for instance, me experimenting with Parikrama as a classical musician was also fusion, but it was very limited. But in Mrigya, we started taking Indian ragas, mixing them with, you know, guitars, drums, bass. So the main composition, the main melodies were based on ragas. And till today, you won't believe the composition, those were done in that 1 week for the first composition are still the same. We haven't changed anything. They were so beautiful then. So we just found a formula of how to blend East and West. It's like, you know, it's a very delicate blend. It's like, you know, putting salt in a dish. If salt is more, you cannot eat. If it's less, you will not enjoy it. So the correct amount of salt to be put in dal is the correct amount of fusion Western element that needs to meet with the Indian element. The most subtle, most delicate combination. So this we have achieved over the years. And we are very fortunate that, you know, Amjad Ali Khan saw us in Edinburgh. And he said that this is one of the most complete world music band I have ever seen. Imagine, you know, coming from such a great classical, you know, maestro, Ustad, when he said this in 2001, too, in Edinburgh. And then, you know, that gave us so much, you know, encouragement, you know, to work more, you know. So.
And your pressure came along with that compliment?
No, there was no pressure. We have always enjoyed, you know, doing what we want to do. And we have always made music. There's so much freedom in this band. Everybody does their own parts. So it's like a great journey. And the formula that I'm talking about is beautiful that we work on.
Since you're performing today at Noida as part of Pyar Ka Naghma, what are your thoughts about Pyar Ka Naghma and a bit of information for our viewers?
Well, today is a very special evening that, you know, we are honoring the great lyricist from the 60s, Shri Santosh Anandji. He's one of the finest, you know, writers Indian film industry has seen. He wrote that beautiful song, Ek Pyar Ka Nagma Hai, which is considered as the millennium song. So, and he is not as well known as other, you know, poets in Bollywood. So the idea was to bring him to the platform and play some of his songs so that, you know, there's going to be a moment of nostalgia as well, and bring him to the stage and, you know, felicitate him.
When talking about that era, do you think that the present generation, Gen X or Gen Y, we call it can connect with that era?
I don't know about what, you know, young kids these days are listening to. There's so much information around, you know. You can listen to anything that you like. But I'm sure there are people who have, because this is a one song which can never go unnoticed, I feel, in anybody's journey, you know. You switch on the radio, somewhere or the other, you know, this song will be playing. You can never ignore, because it's an epic song. It is a timeless song. Ek Pyar Ka Nagma is a timeless song. And so the younger generation, how much they are keen on this kind of music is hard to say. But yes, I suggest they should listen to, you know, the classics from, you know, 60s and 70s.
Finally, your association with News Nation and your views about News Nation and in future, any plans with News Nation?
Well, I'm very thankful to News Nation, you know, for inviting us to perform this on this special day. And all I can say is, you know, all the people that I know in this channel are very good friends of mine. And Sanjay ji is such a musically, you know, he knows so much about music and he knows everything about, you know, how these songs were done then. And me being coming from a Hindustani classical background, so when we sit down, we just talk a lot about music.
Thank you so much, sir, and wish you all the, even though I'm so small a person, thank you so much once again.
Thank you so much. Pleasure.